Hey guys, GWizard here. Today we're gonna play another shitty game. This time on the Game Boy Advance. You're not gonna believe this, but they made a game out of Drake and Josh. Yeah. I don't know why they even made this game. I mean, I don't even like the show, but why they decide to make a game out of it is beyond me. Oh, and listen to this terrible stock music. That shit ain't even the Drake and Josh theme. I mean, why do they have this horrible stock music? It's worse than the stock music in Superman 64. I'm not kidding. Right? So you got a new game, password, or options. Let's start a new game. So yeah, the game starts with the opening, kind of like the show, but they have these horrible caricatures of the characters. Yeah, this is Game Boy Advance, I know. But still, they showed the fucking faces in the beginning, so you would have expected them to use their real faces here, but nah, they just screwed up. I don't give a shit, let's skip it. The next morning. Basically, Drake's late for his class and he has to get there with a hall pass. And we see Megan's shitty caricature. Alright, Drake's school day. And here's the game. Oh, wait. After this crappy cutscene, I'll skip it. This is the game. Yeah, so basically you're just walking around as Drake or Josh in a top-down view. And so let's go to the help. Megan has scattered Drake's guitar pick collections. If he can find all the collections, he can send them in for some cool prizes. Check the trophy room option in the pause menu to see how many picks are scattered in each area. Help Drake find them all. Seems self-explanatory. But that's not your main objective. The main objective here is to get to the class. In the left-hand corner of the screen is a timer. Drake only has a certain amount of time before to reach his objective before it's too late. If you run out of time, you'll have to restart the objective from the beginning. Well, that sucks. All enemies have a cone of vision. Keep behind them, to their side or far away enough, and they won't see you. In the upper left corner is your sneak bar. If people spot you, it will empty. Once empty, you're busted, and you'll have to restart the room. I do not see their cone of vision anywhere. It could probably be an emulator. It's probably an emulator problem. But, whatever. I think this doesn't happen in the actual game. Megan's locked certain doors with a high-tech magnetic system. Activating the corresponding switches opens doors. You'll see which door your switch is activated. Activate the switch without the monitor seeing you. Okay. Alright. Alright. Switch. This game seems self-explanatory, but it's actually not. And we found Drake's guitar. The main hall is locked. You'll have to get a pass for the cafeteria from the librarian's desk to get through the central hall. How does the little kid fucking scare you? I mean, seriously. I know she's evil, but come on. That's what little sisters are. Says one who doesn't have one herself. Oh well, let's go. Watch out for popcorn on the ground. If you walk over it, it'll make... You know what? Fuck these help tips. I'm just going to explain them briefly. See these things? That's what the game calls popcorn. If you walk over them, people might notice you. And I just emptied my sneak bar like a dumbass. But I didn't restart the room. So what do you got to do? You have to press hold B to sneak. And it's kind of like a reverse version of Metal Gear Solid, if you know what I mean. So you got to press the switch, go through here. And it'll be alright. You gotta sneak to get past the popcorn. But all I see is freaking streamers. Oh, shit. How could she freaking see me there? Now I have to restart the room and press the switch again. Way to go, game. Now you just screwed us over. Alright, we're in. Again. You have to be careful again. See, that's why this game is kind of hard. I mean... shit. Go. Yes. You gotta be careful here. Another health tip. Some enemies may walk in a specific path. You may want to study their movements to try and avoid them. Like here. Pattern my ass, they walk at complete random. I think. There's an old bitch. I'm guessing she's a teacher. And that was close. Really, this game literally screws me over. And your sneak bar takes like forever to get full again. I mean, come on, what were they thinking? This part is relatively simple. I mean, I don't see a cone of vision on this emulator, so... By the way, I'm using Weedman Naffin, and it doesn't have a cone of vision. The cone of vision isn't seen. The same problem happens when I try to use VBAGX. Yeah, I already explained the sneak function. Alright, we found the hall passes. I just gotta get back to the central hall. Now, I actually managed to get the hall passes when I played this once, but I didn't even get back in time. Probably because this game's... fuck! Wait, what? Oh, never mind. Whoa, holy shit. Come on. What? I gotta press the switch again? Fuck my life. And I gotta get the passes again. That is freaking fantastic. Must be probably poorly designed or something. It's like that one game I can't even remember for the life of me. Whoa. I have to be really careful this time. Go, 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 go. Yes. Made it. Oh, shit. Gotta get my pick. Okay. Go through here. Wait, didn't I see this room before? No, that's not it. It's particularly easy until you get to this girl. Oh! Fuck. I mean, seriously, who made this? Who designed this game? It's stupid. And keep in mind, this was released after the DS came out, so... Fuck. This was released after the DS came out, so... It's basically a game oriented to younger people. But, I don't know why they made this. Oh look, another hound. Watch out for the webcams that are colored red. They will empty your bar very fast that you won't be able to react. Alright. Slippery floors. You have to be careful. You either gotta sneak or use wise moves. Shit. See what I mean? You can't even control yourself. So your only chance is to sneak, but you're wasting time. Why does this game have to have a goddamn time limit? Yeah, just go past here. Another patrolling guy. You know, I'm curious as to what's down here. I'm not gonna take that chance, though. Oh god, another guy with a red webcam. That is brutal. Hey, look. So basically, you have to get to that door right there and use Drake's guitar. But I never got that. I never got to that part because I couldn't be able to find the switch. Careful. Son of a bitch. Uh-oh. Janitors aren't like the other people. They will hit you, and you'll be temporarily stunned for a while. But at least you don't have to go back to the beginning of the room. There's no switch here. There's only a guitar pick. Oh, shit. That's fucking fantastic. I don't even know where the switch is, for that matter. Alright. Go through here. Go through here. Come on. Whoa. There we go. So yeah, this game is like a maze. I mean, I can't even figure out where I'm going. It doesn't help to have a map or something. Go, go, go. Alright, the switch. There's a switch. It'll open. Of course, that door over there. Only got about 2 minutes and 45 seconds left. I gotta be careful. Come on, 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 come on. Yes! Passed. Yeah. Isn't this another... Yeah, that's another girl. And the door is locked. Fantastic. Two girls patrolling this shit. So I'm gonna open the door. Right there. Now I gotta walk. Whoa. Webcam and the teacher. Damn. Open the switch. Right there. That's relatively simple. 2 minutes left. I better make this quick. Switch. All right. Wait, I wound up back here? Well, then what's the point? What's the point of that room, then? I'm not giving up. I'm going to try to find the right room. That was close. Again. Spotted again. And I have to press the switches again. How awful. Poorly programmed. Stupid popcorn. So you already know how stupid the game is. I can't make it past the first level, and that's because this game is so stupid. So yeah, quit. And I'm not even gonna torture with the stock music again. Oh, and before I finish off this video, THQ made yet another Drake and Josh game on the DS called Drake and Josh Talent Showdown. If I can get my laptop to emulate DS games properly, I might showcase that too. Well, this is G-Wizard signing off, and telling you not to play this crappy game.